Talk about getting your Newton buzz on. Come to you high atop Indica Springs, Colorado. And I mean high. In No Authority Field, home of the Mile High Chronic. Just bought some of those brownies at the Get Baked sale. Man, these guys can bake up here.
I can hear colors, Grim. Hey, Grim, order me one of them corned beef and hash oil sandwiches. I got the munchies something bad.
And today's matchup is going to be a good one. The teams are taking the field. The Galaxy Chaos face off against the Mile High Chronic. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Are you ready for some MFL action?
Am I? I love MILFs. Newtons I'd like to fuck.
He said MFL, not M-I-L-F, you halfwit.
Oh, I thought you were talking about the Mayhem Bowl halftime MILF lingerie girls team. What a zombie QB with that big rack of ribs and almost no waist at all. Ho-ho, va-va-va-voom.
And it's first and ten.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
And it's first and ten. Well, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole.
Second down and ten. Second down and the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Second down and a mile.
Extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
No, still working on my salami here, Briggs. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep.
Well, the defense called a time warp dirty trick, negating that play completely. The offense is pissed.
Well, I wish I had that trick in the elevator with me earlier. I let one rip. I mean, a really good one, Grim. And then the doors open and the team's cheerleaders get on. That's when small talk is really put to the test.
Third down, and the offense needs a miracle. And he's off to the races. Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. And he put all of his foot into that one. And he snags the punt and looks for open field. Oh, with the brain scrambler. And it's first and ten. Sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And that'll bring up second and one. It's first and 10. And he picks up 8 yards on a strong run. Second down and 2. Works at the Mutant Stud Farm weekends and summers.
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Graham.
Right now. And it's first and 10.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
Second down and 7. Gets in there and swats the ball away.
He can't catch, but he sure can swat.
And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7. And he runs it for 4 yards. Ballsy? Stupid, maybe? I guess we'll decide after we see how this goes. But probably stupid. And he runs it in for the touchdown. Well, little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
Oh, look at this guy break tackles. He takes a licking and keeps on ticking. And it's 1st and 10. And then to 1st down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And it's 1st and 10. And he gets 3 yards on that run. Second down and 7. And he's running like a moose right now. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was off to the races. Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Straight through the uprights. looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. And it's first and 10. Shoveled his feet so well on that play, he should go to lost wages and deal cards. First down! And it's first and 10. That's a nice gain of about 7 yards on that run. I thought the only tie we'd see would be a noose. Instead, they're in a dead heat. Tie game at the end of one. Second and 3. First and 10. That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. Second down and 5. They're taking what the defense has given them. That's a 4-yard gain on the reception.
Hey, less than a wipe with a headache.
And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. Well, fee-fi-fo-fum.
They're not finishing.
No one was interested in that incomplete pass.
Not a ball's feelings are hurt.
Hey, don't make me explain that balls don't have emotions again, all right? And kickers practice for this kind of kick every day. Pretty standard.
Nothing standard when you got bloodthirsty mutants on the defensive line.
Well, surprise me, he made it look easy and he gets 3 points for it. And this ref is definitely on the take. That was a bogus penalty. And it looks like the offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Sure love it. They're like a pinata at a Mexican birthday party. Well, here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a life expectancy of 3 returns. But, oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
This guy's going to get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. Second down and 10. And let the work be dirty, Brick. Look at him go. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way.
I'm just about stoned enough right now to go down there and join him. Looks like a good time.
Some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called...
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. First and 10. 3 on that play. Second down and 7. First down and 9. Nice pickup for 6 yards. Second and 3. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
The kick is good.
As expected. Those are pretty much just gimmies.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
First and 10.
Hey, guys, this isn't funny. I swear to drunk, I'm not God, but seriously.
If you don't hear it coming, it'll knock you right on your ass. It's called a sonic blast.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the...
You can tell he's a berserker because he's frothing at the mouth.
Oh!
Oh, the unstoppable force meets the explodable object. Huge! Looks like the defense has it. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? And it's 1st and 10. It for maybe a yard. They've got to open up the offense here, Bricks. Second down and 9. And with a burst of speed, he finds an opening and the first down. And they stop the clock with their first time out to try and stay in this game.
Ah, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point of the game.
I won't listen to this blasphemy!
They used their second timeout, but they are running out of time.
A bit pessimistic, don't you think so, Grim?
It's more about building tension, Bricks. That's all we do at this point. And drink this bourbon. Come on, give me that. And that's a catch for 3 yards. And that's the last time out. They can't stop the clock anymore.
Can any of us really stop the clock, Grim? I mean, when it comes right down to it, are we not all united by the constant reminder of our own mortality? Of death's constant, relentless advance? If only it was as easy. Airball! Hey, did we start letting ghosts into the MFL, Grim?
No, that was just a shitty pass to absolutely no one. I'd be impressed if he splits the uprights from this far away, Bricks.
If he doesn't, they're gonna split his skull wide open.
Straight through the uprights.
Hey, man, he's gonna hit him now. Oh, yeah.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grin?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were gonna tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed, it was a chick wearing a wig.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
And it's first and 10. And he zings it in there for a 9-yard completion. They're moving the ball now with authority. Takes a timeout here. They have two left. I wonder if he has a plan.
Well, maybe he's just gonna take the teeth out of the back of his neck that have been stuck there since the opening play.
Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career. Well, that's two timeouts burned. And you have to wonder, Bricks, are they desperate or are they in control?
I'm speaking from experience, Grim. But it really is hard to do both at the same time. And I have mastered it.
He had it for a second there. And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. And then catch will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has.
And that's it. That's the last time out. It's score or die from here out. And he's going to have to boot this one halfway to hell. Well, surprise me. He made it look easy, and he gets 3 points for it. They need a good return here to set up the offense. They're going to be able to return this one. Oh, he was hit mid-hurdle and fumbles the ball. It's a close battle as the quarter ends. Halftime is brought to you by those caring folks at Monsanto Industries. They make the world a better place by making the government tell you it is. It's anyone's game as the third quarter begins. Both teams have taken their performance-enhancing drugs, and everyone is ready to rock and roll. The teams line up for the second half kickoff.
Yeah, get the hell out of here, man.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and 10. Huge pass play for 1 yard. Second down and 9.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. It's first and ten. Was there, but he still picked up a yard somehow. Second down and nine. Third down and, well, good luck. He rifled that one in there and they come up with 10 yards on the play. And they'll line up for the punt here. Well, that's a lovely shank for the punter today. He just put his, he just let that one drop and played safe, and the defense says, we'll take it. It's first and ten. And he pounds the ball into the defense, picking up seven. Second and three. This is your brain, and this is your brain on Brazil. Dead and down. He just sent a message with that hit.
The message was you can't kill the messenger, because he's going to kill you. But then he won't be able to read the message, because the messenger killed him. Ah, going in circles.
The offense is running low on quarterbacks. They have only two left. They might consider running the ball more. Never happened because the defense called a time warp dirty trick and transport their offense back in time.
It's just a jump to the left
and a step to the right.
And that's a nice run for a first down. And it's first and ten. First and ten. And he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had sewn on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
Nobody can touch me with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about, pal?
Second down and a lot. And an 8-yard gain on that one.
Like when Brix's mom decided to move back in with us.
Third down and three. Perfect pass, and he scores handily. They need to call an attack ref dirty trick and stop this, or they're going to lose.
Not like they need any help with that, though, Grim. These guys are doing fine by themselves.
Third down and long, and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. Third down and forever. It shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It's good. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And it's first and 10. Defense holds him to a 4-yard pickup there. Second down and 6. Knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
And it's first and 10. He was starting to go somewhere, but he gets stomped after 3.
They usually stop me after 3, too. You know, the all-you-can-eat buffets? They're not as literal as you'd think.
Killer, it was right there, and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in fantasy league.
And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7. And the quarterback drills one in for the 1st down. That's the end of 3, and it's anyone's game. Hang on tight. The 4th quarter is about to begin. And it's 1st and 10. Oh, the receiver has to make that catch. Now he put the team in a hole. 2nd down and 10.
I've seen this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
And the crowd goes wild! Touchdown! Touchdown! And they come to the line trying to tie this up with 2 points.
And if they don't, things are going to get weird and desperate on this side.
And the defense stops them cold. That play just got blown to hell.
Yeah, it got blown to shit.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. That hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's 1st and 10. Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
2nd down and 6.
Move, baby? No, you didn't. You know why? I'm too fast for you. I'm the greatest. The greatest, I tell you.
And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7. reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. And it's first and 10. And the defense spiked the offensive water with Strawberry Fields. And now they can taste sound but can't remember what the concept of time is.
Seriously, man, you think you'll go toe-to-toe with me? You get my grill, I'll ruin your world. Ruin it.
Second down and long. The defense called a warp speed turn and he could go all the way. They go to the ground game and pick up the first. Nicely done. And it's first and 10. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
And they line up for the extra point. Straight through the uprights. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
First and 10.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not your own.
And the offense says, I don't think so. They called a time warp dirty trick and negate that previous play like it never happened.
Did it? Does that mean that I didn't just chug this beer too? I am so confused.
Second down and 10. He picks up a 2. Third down and 8. Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get the return man catches the ball and heads upfield. Oh, with the brutal hit.
Yo, man, nobody can touch me with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
And it's first and 10. Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and 10. Pick up 9 with that catch.
Not enough for first, but still a nice game.
We're at the 2-minute mark in the second half. And that'll bring up second and 1. quarterback calls a sonic blast dirty trick and throws. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! I like this. They're going for two. And the MFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8. The greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Well.
And the defense is on his heels. He's at the 40. The 30. The 20. He's at the 10. Oh, and it's a clusterfuck. That's the rarest play in the NFL. Look, guys, I'm supposed to be impartial, but this ref is so dirty, he should be where he's most at home, buried in the dirt. The offense lost another quarterback on the previous play and have only two left before they have to forfeit.
Yeah, but on the bright side, Glenn, they save a ton of money by not having to pay those guys anymore. That is.
Hey, Bricks, they're going for two here. The defense had enough with this rep and jumps off sides to kill him. They want more points, so they're going for two. Bam! Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
The offense has only one quarterback left. If he dies, it's game over. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
And he finds open space, he's running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
And they take their first time out.
How predictable. Surprise us next time. Call the timeout during halftime.
Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a two-minute drill. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done. Greedy or desperate, either way, they're going for two. And they run it in for 2 points. The kicker's going to have to kick the ball just right so his team can recover it. The four people on the planet who care about rules and kickoffs must be happy to see a flag down.
I'm just happy to see anything after that laser pointer accident.
The onside kick is a desperation play, but it's their only chance at this point to steal a possession. Come on, it's not that hard to kick, is it? Because this guy's making it look really hard.
Maybe he's just having a bad leg day. I get those, you know, the Jimmy legs.
Every day with you is a fucking bad everything day.
And it's first and ten.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
At this point, they're going to have to get the ball back by any means necessary. Or wasting two timeouts on the defense is really going to bite them in the ass. Ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to bite it.
The Mile High Chronic celebrates a brutal win by forfeit. The groundskeeper will be sweeping up body parts all night long. They come up big today with a solid win, and the opposition will be licking their wounds on the long plane ride home.
I have wounds taste just like chicken. How was it? Scrambles tomato soup.
Wounds.
The MVP is about to inspire us with some words of wisdom. Yeah, right. Putting three words together for this guy is like you doing a Rubik's Cube.
What's a Rubik's Cube?
Moving on.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the MicroHard Corporation. They get it right every up.